They are divided into two groups, anterior and posterior. In anterior group, you already know two muscles. What is it? Musculus pectoralis major and musculus pectoralis major. Mm-hmm. Both of these muscles are muscles of the chest, but they are also muscles of shoulder girdle because they attach to humerus and to the scapula and moves shoulder girdle and arm. That is why they are anterior muscles of the shoulder girdle. Also, here it is another muscle. I show you on the corp. It is musculus coracobrachialis. It starts from coracoid process and go to humerus. It performs flexion in shoulder joint in girdle. Posterior muscles of the shoulder girdle are musculus. Help me. Deltoidus. That is deltoid muscle. It starts from acromial part of the clavicle. From acromion and from spinal scapula. Posterior fibers of this muscle take place in extension, anterior fibers flexion, and whole muscle perform abduction of the hand to horizontal level. Above of horizontal level, if you remember, which muscles take place? Trapezius, serratus anterior, and musculus rhomboideus. Next, posterior muscles are musculus supraspinatus. It starts from fossa supraspinata of the scapula and attached to great intubicle of the humerus. Abduction, main function of this muscle, abduction of the hip. Musculus infraspinatus starts from fossa infraspinata of the scapula and attached to great cubicle of the humerus. Function, rotation, supination of the humerus. Next, musculus teres minor. The same start from scapula, from lateral body of the scapula and attached to great cubicle. Function, supination of the hand. Next, musculus teres major, major muscle. It starts from inferior angle of the scapula and go together with musculus, help me. Let's see, dorsi, and attach to crista tuberculi minoris of the humerus. Perform adduction and pronation of the humerus. And here it is absent, musculus subscapularis. It occupies anterior surface of the scapula. If you remember, fossa subscapularis of the scapula, and attach to lesser tubercle of the humerus. Tuberculum minus. Function, adduction of the hand, pronation, and pronation. Okay. That is posterior muscles of the shoulder girdle. Next, let's go to body. Well, first of all, what is this muscle?
Deltoid
muscle. Do you remember it's attached to tuberositas deltoida of the humerus? Well, next, I promise to show you muscle musculus coracobrachialis. Look here, it is coracoid process of the scapula. That is part of musculus pectoralis minor. It's attached to coracoid process. And musculus coracobrachialis, here it is. It starts from coracoid process and attached to humerus. Musculus coracobrachialis. Next, muscles of the arm. Muscles of the arm divides into anterior and posterior group. Anterior group consists of two muscles. First muscle, and it is most popular muscle, what is? Musculus biceps brachii, biceps. Musculus biceps brachii. Biceps consist of two heads, long and short. It is it is short, mm-hmm. and here it is long. It is not look like long head, yes? It's look shorter, but if you remember, long head of biceps pass in groove sulcus intertubercularis, and tendon of this muscle pass through shoulder joint and start from tuberculum supraglenoidale of the scapula. That is why this head start here, pass through shoulder joint, and attach together with short head in one muscle, and this muscle attached to radius. And short head of biceps start from coracoid process together with musculus coracobrachialis, and it is the same process where musculus pectoralis minor attach. Function of biceps. It perform flexion in shoulder joint and flexion in elbow joint. Next anterior muscle, it is musculus brachialis, brachial muscle. It starts from anterior surface of the humerus and attached to radius. Main function, flexion in elbow joint. And two posterior muscles necessary to know. Posterior muscles are triceps, musculus triceps brachii. It consists of three heads: long head, lateral head, and here it is medial head. Long, lateral, and medial. And tendon of this muscle attached to olecranon on the ulna. Function, extension in elbow joint, extension in shoulder joint. Next muscle, below of triceps, here it is impossible to see. It's below of triceps, start from both epicondyles of humerus and attached to olecranon. It has triangular shape and name of this muscle, musculus anconeus. Anconeus. Function, extension in elbow joint. Next, topography. Topography of the arm. First of all, fascia. I think you know that musculus pectoralis has fascia, fascia pectoralis. It has two layers, superficial and deep. Superficial surround musculus pectoralis minor and deep musculus pectoralis minor. Fascia pectoralis continue into fascia deltoide and into fascia axillaris in axillary cavity. And these two fascia continue into fascia brachialis. Fascia brachialis surround muscles of the arm. Fascia brachialis. And this fascia attached to humerus laterally here and medially here, and separate anterior muscles from posterior muscles. And this septum has name septum intermusculare laterale on lateral surface, and septum intermusculare mediale on medial surface. And also here it is present two grooves, sulcus bicipitalis medialis, it's between biceps and musculus brachialis, and sulcus bicipitalis lateralis is also between biceps and musculus brachialis. In these two grooves, vessels and nerves pass. And last moment on the arm, canalis humera muscularis. In name of this canal, we can know what? Two walls, humerus and muscles. Canalis humera muscularis consists of humerus and muscles. This canal is on posterior surface of the humerus. That is why humerus and muscle, what is this muscle? Triceps, canal between triceps and humerus. And in this canal, radial nerve pass, nervus radialis, radial nerve. Just a moment. It is radial nerve, and radial nerve, go into this canal and surround posteriorly humerus, between humerus and triceps. That is why radial nerve pass in canalis humera muscularis. And last moment, it is axillary cavity. Axillary cavity. If we abduct our hand, we can see yourself what? Axillary fossa. But if we remove skin and subcutaneous fat, like here, it is absent skin and fat, we can see axillary cavity. And this axillary cavity has four walls. Anterior wall of axillary cavity formed with the help of what? What is this muscles? Pectoralis major and minor. Musculus pectoralis major and minor. That is anterior wall. Posterior wall consists of musculus subscapularis, then musculus teres major, and musculus latissimus dorsi. These muscles on posterior wall of axillary cavity. Now, medial wall of axillary cavity. Help me. What is the name of this muscle?
Anterior.
James, I put you today 7. Why 7? Because you don't know fascia of the neck, but you know musculus serratus anterior. It is good. Musculus serratus anterior formed medial wall of axillary cavity and lateral wall, humerus, musculus coracobrachialis and musculus triceps. It is on lateral wall. And in axillary cavity, necessary to know topography of posterior wall and topography of anterior wall. On posterior wall present two openings, one of them here. Name of this opening, foramen quadrilaterum, and another opening is here, foramen trilaterum. Foramen quadrilaterum and trilaterum. They separated with the help of long head of triceps. Now I draw diagram at the blackboard and it will be more easy for you. Two openings on posterior wall and three triangles necessary to know on anterior wall. First triangle between clavicle superiorly and superior border of musculus pectoralis minor, it is trigonum clavi pectorale. Next triangle trigonum pectorale and last trigonum subpectorale. I also draw it at the blackboard. Topography of posterior wall of axillary cavity. That is scapula, it is cavitas glenoidalis and humerus. Scapula and humerus. Anterior surface of the humerus, of scapula, occupied with the help of musculus subscapularis. It is musculus subscapularis. Musculus subscapularis. Let's go to lesser tubercle of the humerus, tuberculum minus. Next muscle below of musculus subscapularis, it is musculus teres major, major muscle, musculus teres major, teres major muscle, musculus teres major. And it is triceps, long head of triceps. And this long head starts from tuberculum infraglenoidalis, from scapula, start from the scapula in the region of tubercle, tuberculum infraglenoidalis. And we receive two openings, foramen trilaterum and foramen quadrilaterum. Both of these foramen has superior wall. What is it? Superior wall. Musculus? No, superior wall. Musculus? Subscapularis. Inferior wall?
Teres major.
Teres major. And lateral wall in foramen quadrilateral, it is humerus. And medial wall separate trilateral and quadrilateral, long head of triceps. And it is humerus, it is sagittal neck of the humerus, laterally. Laterally, it is sagittal neck of the humerus. That is posterior wall of axillary cavity. Now, anterior wall. Anterior wall of axillary cavity. It is present two muscles, musculus pectoralis major, and below of musculus pectoralis major, present musculus pectoralis minor, posteriorly from pectoralis major, musculus pectoralis minor. And above of musculus pectoralis minor, between clavicle and upper body of musculus pectoralis minor, first triangle has name trigonum clavi pectorali, between clavicle and pectoral muscle. Trigonum clavi pectorali. Second triangle, it is opposite of musculus pectoralis minor. Trigonum pectorale, pectoral triangle. Trigonum pectorale. And third triangle, between lower body of musculus pectoralis minor and lower body of musculus pectoralis major. And name of this triangle, trigonum subpectorale, subpectoral triangle. Trigonum subpectorale. That is all. Come here and give me manual. We look at your manual, what you will prepare. Come here.
You start at page topic 6, page 240H. Muscles of the brachium till 253, but then you pass muscles of forearm and hand, you pass it, not necessary to read, and it is you read these two paragraph, half part of this page 267, half part, upper half of the page, from the beginning till antebrachial fascia, till here. Then, topography of upper limb. You start to read topography of upper limb till cubital fossa. In front of elbow joint, not necessary to read, about cubital fossa, till here. From the beginning, from topography of upper limb, page 269, till middle part of 270. It is clear?
Yes, sir.
Now that is all.
Thank you, sir.